Hiya, my name's Thomas Craig and I play Frankie in Act 1 of the Armour. I play a rock manager who manages Jade, who's played by Hannah Spirit from S Club 7, and she's having a bit of a meltdown and I'm trying to get her on stage. She's due in the O2 Arena any minute. We've got a helicopter booked ready to land on the roof of the hotel and she's playing silly buggers. So I'm trying to get her out of the hotel and onto the helicopter and to the O2 Arena. I'd never met Hannah before, but one of my favourite covers ever, The Beautiful South, do a brilliant cover of Don't Stop Moving. And I've played it for her tonight, actually, for the first time. And it's a fantastic cover version of Don't Stop Moving. So it's really weird because I wasn't an S Club 7 fan. I was a bit old when they were out, but she's a great girl, really good. She's a trooper.
And what do you think your act in particular brings to the production overall?
Our act is in a slightly bigger room, so we move around a lot more. It is intimate, but it's not as intimate as the second play, which is very intimate. And the third play, I think there's a little bit more energy and a bit more oomph to our house. It opens the show with a bit of boom. Yeah.
And I'd imagine that as a performer, not just for an audience, it's a unique experience working in a venue like this. Can you talk a little bit about performing in the hotel?
Yeah, well, when I got the audition for the job, I thought, wow, that sounds interesting. So I went online and saw that they did the Tennessee Williams plays last year, and it just seemed very interesting. It's almost like I've been doing a lot of TV the last 6 months, but it's almost like acting for TV but on stage because it's so intimate and you don't have to kind of project like you would in a normal theatre. So it's quite a mix of the two, being on stage but very intimate.
What themes do you think, if any, kind of tie it all together? What's the overall production about?
Well, there's a tenuous link with a jacket that Napoleon left France with that ends up Hannah wears in the first act. But I think each play deals with kind of like somebody's got the upper hand and somebody wants to... The person who's got the power is being kind of manipulated by the other person. So... Yeah, there's a kind of power struggle going on in each act. Well, you know, as an actor, most actors get into being an actor because they do plays when they're younger. So you never actually, I never imagined I'd be on TV. I just thought I'd do theatre. So it's different, you know. I love theatre, but there's just no money in it. I've been doing a show in Canada for the last 8 years, actually. I go to Toronto every summer to do a show called The Murdoch Mysteries. I play the police chief of Toronto in 1900. So I'm off in May to do season 9 of that. It's on the Alibi channel in England, and it's pretty big all around the world, apart from in America, which is pain.
I'm curious, I mean, obviously, you're going into season 9. What do you think is the secret of the show's long-running success?
It's a very historical show about Canada, and there's not a lot of Canadian shows that are dealing that, and the Canadians have really took to it because they import a lot of American shows, as we all do. But so there's not many Canadian shows, and we're like the number one show in Canada. We're the number one show after ice hockey. Hockey's the biggest, and then Murdoch Mysteries.
And what can fans expect from season 9?
I don't know if they watch it. One of the main characters has been accused of assassinating somebody at the end of season 8, so we will be dealing with the fallout from that. And Murdoch, the lead character, has just got married to the lead woman, and that's been an ongoing on-off relationship for 8 seasons, and they got married in episode 100.
I mean, a wonderful way to celebrate your 100th episode. How do you think that's going to change the nature of the show, having them finally married off?
Yeah, I'm not sure, but that's what everybody said. I don't know. I mean, we've done a 114 episodes, so they've only been married for 14. Yeah, they were courting for 100 episodes. I don't go on social media, so I don't tweet or Facebook, but it'd be nice if Murdoch Mysteries fans knew that I was doing this play and they came along to the Langham Hotel and experienced the hotel and experienced the production. 3 great little 20-minute plays and 5 great actors plus me.